Got us talking about sports in Nigeria. Athletes did what they could. Self-will pushed them. Motivation, commitment. They did a lot of things themselves. Segun Odegbami is, how do you describe him now? It's been there, done that with football in Nigeria. Former Green Eagles captain. And when I talked to him, he struggled to find a way out of all of these problems because we are not just making ways to get out of it. But he mentioned something. He said, our attitude must change. Let's listen to the mathematical. I'll be right back.
Highlight is Nigeria's qualification for the World Cup. It defines the totality of football. You measure football by what you achieve, really. And I think that is, really indicative of progress in Nigerian football. Beyond that, I don't see anything else. Our domestic football hasn't really changed much.
Yeah, true.
At international club level, we haven't achieved much. So it's really about the national team, and when you look closely at even that, you find that the strategy we adopted is what actually fetched us that victory. But that is the main highlight for me for 2017. Well, we must just have hope. We must just have hope, because all the indicators on ground do not give one confidence that anything will change. But we must change our attitude. We must have hope that things will change somehow. I don't know how. So that's my own personal attitude in 2018.
Segun Odegbami, former Green Eagles captain. Look, it says we did some things right, and then we qualified for the World Cup. But in 2018, everybody said we must hope some more. But while we're hoping, we should also change our attitude. Ministry for Youth and Sports, there's a calendar. You know some persons will be at a competition in August. This is January. Start planning towards August. Don't tell us in July that funding is a problem. Funding will be a problem because you haven't changed what you were doing 3, 4, 5, 6 years ago.
The attitude has to change. And as one of my favorite quotes from Albert Einstein is, insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. And it'll be outright insanity if we come out in 2018 and keep talking about funding. Like you said, Austin, there's a plan.
I mean, you know the Commonwealth Games.
Federations have already submitted their plans and say, these are the competitions that we need to attend in 2018.
Yeah.
Nigeria must be at this competition.
So you knew 4 years before that time.
Obviously.
Obviously.
Yeah. So you have it. This is where you need the amount of funds we need.
Yeah.
I'm sure all of that is on the table.
Okay.
They need to go and find funds from anywhere.
That's right.
They need to find funds because, for instance, if you look at... If we're to go, we're going to the World Cup.
Yeah.
Nobody's going to talk about the fact that there's no fun. You can't say that. Yeah. Nigerians will stone you.
Uh-huh.
If you say there's no money for us to go and play
after we qualify, play at the World Cup, of calculators.
We'll stone you. We'll stone you. Nigerians will stone you, literally. Yeah. So the same commitment we give to football has to go through the other federations.
Right.
Because we can't just be talking about football.
Yeah.
Also, look at our neighbor, South Africa.
Oh, goodness.
They're not doing so well in football. They've got a fantastic league, but they're not, because I think personally, they don't have enough talent like we do. But look at their league.
Okay.
Look at what they're doing in rowing, in athletics.
Okay.
Wade Van Niekerk is in 400 meters, world champion, world record holder.
The Olympics and
look at Caster Semenya, 800 meters, world champion. They're doing things elsewhere.
Oh, you need to mention cricket, rugby. South Africa.
Chatlo Klo in doing great stuff in swimming. So we need to start looking at the different federations, not just football.
Yeah.
Look at the different federations.
Yeah.
We'll put money here. This is the competition you need to do. You need money for training. You need money for these guys to train. We'll put it down.
And when you do that, when you take the pressure of football, because now you're going to the Commonwealth Games, and it's not just football.
Mm.
It's weightlifting. It's boxing. It's table tennis. It's basketball. It's sports.
Austin,
the Olympics is sports.
We cannot be going to tournaments and come back without medals. It's so embarrassing to a nation as big and as huge and as talented as Nigeria. We cannot be going to tournaments and come back and say we tried our best. There was no funding. Absolute nonsense, in my opinion. It shouldn't happen again in 2018.
And someone will look back and say, but you have the market.
Mm.
And while we're saying that football has done the right things in your ball, while we're saying that the government, the Ministry for Youth and Sports should support other sports, those federations president in your ball, they need to get to work.
Yeah.
Table tennis. There was a time we were respected all over the world. Yomi Bankole, Atonde Musa, Cecilia Ariye. I'm calling world-class table tennis players, and then
We came down to Olufunke Oshonaike in a time, still active, Segun Toriola. Now we talked about Arnold Quadri being world number 20, package it.
Sit down and how do we, also we've talked about it over and over again, and I'm not afraid to repeat it because you've got to say it so much so that you can get into someone's ear. Peradventure someone would take notice and say we need to do the right thing.
Yeah.
Because it's not just about the talent. It's not just about the fact that we're a good table tennis country.
Yeah.
We need to sit down as federation, the different sports federation, they need to sit down and say, how can we invite companies, multinationals, how can we invite private sponsorship into what we do?
Yeah.
How can, because the truth of the matter is that if you start getting sponsorship, you take a huge burden off the shoulder of the federal government.
That's right.
Now, when you sit down and map out strategies, sit down and say, we can attract this. And the issue of integrity, the issue of transparency,
accountability
has got to be top class, because these multinationals won't put a dime in whatever thing you do.
I mean, organizational name is involved. You mess it up, they are also in it.
Austin, the Nigerian Football Federation, over the years, who struggled for sponsorship.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, look at what Amaju Pinning and the guys are doing. ITO came on board.
Yeah.
Put a lot of money in Nigerian football. Mm. Look at the cup final, the ITO cup final, where
that's
me and
about.
Myself and you were there.
Yeah, we're not hearing about
a spectacle.
Being struggling to pay coaches. We went through the qualifying series. No player said they didn't give us our bonus, our allowances, and that was why it was good. But Nyobong, above all this, what we're saying is, until we have a will to succeed, until we have policies, structures, persons that are purpose-driven, that are passionate, that love sports. Not a federation president. I can't even talk to the press. Something is going wrong in your federation and you just can't talk to the press. You're not ready to lead. That tells you right there that you can't talk to the press about his federation. Is he going to market that same federation?
And the truth of the matter is that if, as the head of a federation, if you're doing things right, you'll be running to the press every time.
That's right.
You'll be eager. You want to tell
them. If you're doing it right, then you need help. Mm. That's where to go.
Now, we'll run out and say, this is what we're doing. This is where we're lacking. These are challenges we've got at the moment. So the fact that they're not coming to the press just tells the whole story in my opinion.
Tells the story that we're still doing the same old things and it's going to be there. That's what Segun Odegbami says, with the signs, the indicators, this is what he used, that we can only hope. Let's go on this final break. When we come back, the English Premier League will get our attention. Don't go anywhere.